top of that building, really high up in the sky. Don't look now, look, he's falling. Well, I sure hope that he can fly. Peter, well, we know fiction isn't fair. You weren't the best one. Well, did you have to cut your hair? Don't scream, it's deafening silence. You turn the black night into red. Gotta run, the people call.
1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2.
'Cause you exploded at the end of season one. Oh, Peter, looks like it all went wrong. Oh, Peter, we know fiction isn't fair. You were the best one. Well, did you have to cut your hair? You exploded at the end of season one. Oh, Peter, looks like it all went wrong. Oh, Peter. Oh, Peter. Oh, Peter.
That's a band from Derrystoke, Londonderry, called The Wonder Villains, and that's a track called Oh Peter. It's from a collection of Northern Ireland music, which was put out, as they say, earlier on this year. Northern Ireland Music 2011, featuring all the bands. Cashier number 9, Paul Casey. But that's one of the better ones, I think. We'll have to do something about the sound here. We're continually being complained to. And I know that probably you have to field a lot of complaints in there about maybe perhaps the music is too loud, and then when the music finishes, the people who come on talking, which is namely you and me, they can't hear us. This is usually preferable. People don't really want to hear us. They want to hear the music, but they don't want to hear us. But then there are other people, you know, twisted people, who want to hear what we say. And then sometimes they say that they have to turn us up because the music is too loud.
But your music goes up.
But it's nothing to do with me. I can't help it. I am told by the BBC that you must keep your music between 4 and 5 and 5 and 6, all that kind of thing. So I look religiously at my little dial, and then when I begin to talk, I look at the little dial and I see that that's where the thing is. So in theory, my voice should be at the same level as the music, but then people ring up and say, "That music's twice as loud as you talking." So I can't do that. It's beyond my control. And our engineer goes and gets a haircut, and then Ken's away in Portugal. Nobody cares. It's as if there's nobody in charge of the store. Do you think I should write to someone?
I don't really.
You don't care, do you?
No, I do care.
You don't
care.
Give two
I
hoots.
Do care. I
you don't
do
care about how people hear us.
I
That's
do
because
care,
you have no love. Do you know what it is? You have no love for this programme.
No, people complain.
And you
complain.
Don't like the listeners.
People complain when they talk to you on the phone that they can't hear you.
But that's a normal thing. That happens on radio also all the time. But this is a thing that I can't get to the bottom of, the disparity between the music and the voice. That doesn't happen really well all the time. It doesn't happen to me on a Friday. It's something to do with this thing in front of me. I mean the
yes,
microphone.
Yes, I understand.
It's something to do with that. I think we need a different mic. Anyway, the people don't want to hear that.
All right.
They don't want to hear you not being interested in anything I'm saying. What they want, what are you reaching for there?
New headphones, because these headphones are extremely loud.
No, it's not the headphones are extremely loud. The whole thing is up the swanny. That's what it is. Put those new headphones on and you'll see there's no difference.
Right, hold on.
Okay.
There's me changing.
Yeah, I see that. Got your grid at changing.
Right, let me hear now.
Yeah,
you're low.
Yeah,
well,
situation.
How, explain that to me.
What?
How come one set of headphones, the set that I'm wearing now, are fine?
But that's what I'm saying to you. There are so many unanswered questions in the studio. We need more help here. We need people, professional people, who should be in here instead of getting haircuts and going to Portugal. That's all I'm saying. We're here every day. We don't go to Portugal. I go other places. But we're here. I mean, left. Sorry, am I ranting today?
I'll tell you something.
I'll just have to say hello.
I'll tell you something now.
Go ahead. Who's dressing Rory McIlroy?
Very bad. Very
what
bad
is going
hair.
On
very
here?
Very bad hair. I said you. I
did
said,
you see him in his suit yesterday in Wimbledon? Now, I love Rory McIlroy, but somebody's going to have to work with him. The hair is very bad, and your theory is that he's losing it.
I think he's going bald.
And you think he's plastering it down mm-hmm. to hide the wee baldy bits? Mm-hmm. I don't think so. I think you're wrong. I think he thinks he needs an advisor. He needs to come to me.
I was right about his putting. I'm right about his hair.
You were right about his putting. Yes. Yeah, I have to confess, I have to give that to you. Mm-hmm. Because you were castigated wrongly.
That's
because
right.
when he lost the Masters, yes. you said it was because he couldn't putt. Mm-hmm. And everybody was saying, what does he know, that Coyle guy?
Yeah.
And then a man came along and said the reason why he lost the Patters was what, the yeah, Patters, the Masters, is because he couldn't putt. Mm-hmm. But he said, I went along and I fixed that in
that's
10 right. minutes.
Yes,
but
right.
you saw it.
Yes.
You saw it.
Mm-hmm.
And he fixed it. Fair play to you, Sean.
Thank you.
Do you know what I say? Yeah. Huzzah, I say, hurrah to you.
Anyway, dude, I'm thinking now.
Somebody needs to vent. He went to Wimbledon wearing a suit and a white shirt that he'd get out of pound stretchers and a big pink tie and his hair all plastered down. He looked like the guy that came in from the country. Do you know what I mean? In for the day.
Aye.
Somebody needs to talk to him because he doesn't need that kind of, you know, bumpkin thing. He needs to talk to him. He's representing us trendy people. But I love him. I think he's great. But, you know, you don't want to see him looking like a geek, do you?
No, I do not.
You
no,
don't want
no,
to see him no, looking like a geek. No, because no. everybody else saying, there's boys looking at your man, he looks like a geek. That's no. what they're saying, not here, because we're all geeks. But people in England are saying, look at that fella, look at the state of him. That's all I'm saying. Anyway, there's a gentleman. Sorry, mate.
I'm beginning to listen.
To me?
No, not to you.
I know that.
I'm beginning to listen to the health and safety men. They're getting through to me.
Oh, my God.
Aye.
At last.
You know the health and safety men in the BBC?
They were here yesterday.
Right. But you know, they're everywhere. They're everywhere.
You know
Bulletin sites and everywhere.
No, but particularly the BBC ones. They're very good at their job.
Yes,
but you
yes.
don't listen to them.
No.
If you listened to them, you'd be, every time you take a breath, you'd be testing the air.
I thought yesterday, I said to myself, I'm going to put streamers on my fan.
I thought you only did that at the weekend.
That's what I said to myself. I says, my fan needs streamers.
No, but don't do that. Because you know what'll happen then?
Why?
So those streamers may not be entirely clean. And when you put them on the fan and the fan goes, the fan may blow germs from the streamers into your lungs, thereby causing you irreparable damage. You hadn't thought of that, did
Never?
You?
Never, no.
See, every time you take a breath, you should go, I don't want to breathe yet. Just test that air. It's all right. That's okay. No, but you see, you're very much like this. I'm surprised that you never listened to them before. You're the man who won't let dogs shite on the new bridge.
Oh, stop it.
But I mean, you know.
Stop.
Yes, that's the man you are. You're the man who wants to mow down skateboarders with guns. You're the man who wants to have a hotel for dogs.
I
throw away the key.
I actually complained to a former mayor of this city last night who was out having a drink, out socialising, and we were talking. He said, have you seen Beyond the Bridge? I said, yes, it's a pity about the dogs. Can you not do something about the dogs?
He says, an ex-mayor is having a drink?
Yes.
And you complained to him
yes.
about dogs and the bridge? I'm sure he was glad to see you coming. What did he say? Go on, reenact the conversation. Now, I'm the mayor.
Right.
I'm having a drink. Jesus Christ, off there. You're an R.P. dad. Yeah, I must go for a fag.
No, I don't think he smokes.
I'm just being a mayor.
I know.
I'm not
know.
Being an A mayor. In particular.
That's great to not be the mayor. When you're a mayor, you're running around doing everything. It's great to be able to do nothing. Just sit here and. Hold on, there's a boy coming.
No, I came in and he had a very big hello for me.
Hello!
As big as that, aye.
Sean.
Aye. And I says,
how's it going, Sean?
I says, great, former mayor.
Thank you. What about you? What about that young lad up in Radio 5? How's he getting on? Young Anderson lad.
No, it called you No Chin.
The mayor called me No Chin.
Former mayor.
The former mayor.
A former mayor. Not the former mayor.
In other words, not the last one.
No.
No chin. Yeah. But see, this is against nature because I have quite a prominent chin.
I know. Well.
Why does he think I have no chin?
Well, I just said.
I see. He's going the other way.
Maybe. So how's No Chin doing?
So what did you
days?
Say?
I said he's fine. I said, is he with you tonight?
Where is he tonight?
I know that, you see.
Where is he tonight?
So many people ask that. Where is he tonight? Where is it? I don't know. You know. Where is it?
They never ask me where you are.
Do they not?
Never.
Oh, that's hateful.
They always ask me, when I go on holidays, they always ask me where you are.
Oh, there you are.
And I always say the same thing.
What?
Go away.
Oh.
I always say to them. So what did you say to him then? Well, Mr. Ex-Mayor from way back, I have something to say to you about the dogs on the peace bridge.
No, he said to me, have you been over the new bridge yet?
Let me say that.
Have you been over the new bridge yet? Our new peace bridge, which will bring all people together and make people love one another the way they should always have done, but had no sense.
And I said, yes, I was over last night.
Well, I'm so glad that you had the opportunity to traverse our bridge. And what do you think of the transpontine scenery whilst you were over there? Did you meet many Protestant people? And aren't they just the same as us?
And I says, it was wonderful, but it's a pity about the dogs. He says, we're inundated with complaints.
He said?
I am inundated with complaints about dogs on our peace bridge, fouling the footpath where ordinary people have to walk. But what I was saying to myself is this, how come in other parts of the world there are little boxes where you can get your little pieces of paper and tick your dog shite and put it into them boxes and then boys collect it later? Why can we not do that like normal civilized people?
Well, he didn't say that, but what I said to him, he said...
I'd like to thank you for electing me to this prestigious post. I shall do whatever I can to bring the two portions of our population together and promote peace and harmony from now until I have to stop.
He says, I never thought about the dogs. He says, but sir, what's the answer?
I never thought about the dogs, but as I often said to my wife, what's the answer?
And then I said to him,
what is the answer, Sean?
Says, ban the dogs. And he nearly fell off his stool.
Ban the dogs?
That's what he said.
Ban the dogs?
And then he says, jeepers, I never thought about that.
Jeepers, I never thought of that.
Aye. I said, do you think, could we get away with that?
Do you think that we could get away with that, Sean?
I said, well, why couldn't you?
Why don't we just kill them all, put them all down, and then there'll be no more trouble?
What do you think of that, Sean?
Nobody
asked me.
What did he ask you, Sean?
How do you stop it, Sean? I says, you tell them no dogs. You put up a big sign, do not take your dog across the peace bridge.
Can I be myself again?
Yes.
I think it's shameful the way you have no consideration for the lives and the happiness of our four-legged friends.
They never let us down.
Special dog bridge.
They go over the Craig Adam Bridge.
The people should be allowed to bring their pets.
No.
They should then.
Carry them. wants to go to the toilet. That's let it go to the toilet.
I think I'll take my dog for a carry tonight. Yes. I think I'll call it carry out. A gentleman said, I don't want to talk about this anymore because I can see that you're being unreasonable. And let me just say this. Many people out there listening are beginning to dislike you greatly because of your unbending attitude.
The council could sell little plastic pants to the dogs.
But I would never wear them. I very much enjoyed your featurette yesterday, says a man who contacts this programme, where you pressed Sean to give the name of a prominent figure within broadcasting whom he dislikes. I would like to suggest you continue this theme this morning by making him choose who he would rather play a round of golf with. OK. Would you rather play a round with Rory McIlroy or Graham McDowell? And give me the reasons for this. If you had to pick.
I had to pick one of the
I would pick Rory even though I don't play.
I think I would go for Graham.
Why?
I think Rory just maybe...
Might be dull?
No, we...
Might beat you?
No. I think
might,
he's just
might not be interesting, might
young.
Not be able to talk
too,
about
too
people's
young.
Wife.
Too young.
Too young for you?
If you know what I mean. I think you'd talk
You prefer you. Pensioners. Okay.
I would go for Graham McDowell.
Paul Clark or Noel Thompson?
Noel Thompson.
Well, there's no question there because he's a friend of yours.
Yes.
Elvis Presley or Roy Orbison?
Elvis.
What's wrong with Roy? Of course, he wouldn't be able to see the ball. Paul Daniels or Jimmy Savile?
Savile.
What's wrong with Paul Daniels? Too weak.
Couldn't bear him.
Could you not?
No.
Good. This is going well. You're starting to dislike people. I like the way you're turning out. Gordon Burns, Krypton Factor, or Henry Kelly, Going for Gold, ancient TV programmes.
Gordon Burns.
Oh, I think so. Henry Kelly's unbearable. Jim McDonald.
What about you?
Or Liz McDonald.
Was that the Coronation Street couple?
The Coronation Street couple, yeah.
Could a pass in both?
Well, Liz McDonald, she wouldn't be able to see the ball.
Why not?
Because of her chest. And finally, Angela Rippon or Stephen Nolan? Alice, you have to think carefully of this one because you dislike both of them.
Aye.
Who would you choose?
Angela Rippon or Stephen Nolan?
Uh-huh. That's it.
Do I have to pick one?
Yes, you have. Before we go on, I'm not moving on until you pick one. Come on.
I think I'll go for Nolan.
I think so.
Yeah.
Another lady says, a gentleman whom I would imagine you'd be familiar with, if I may use that expression, was on BBC Breakfast this morning, a man called Dwayne Eddy.
Ah.
You see, I knew it. Positive reaction.
Yeah.
Dwayne Eddy, of course, 40 miles of bad road.
Your mum's a big fan of his.
Who?
Radio 2 man that you liked. Johnny Walker.
Johnny Walker, like Dwayne Eddy. Dwayne Eddy was a very interesting guy. He's getting on a bit now. Mm-hmm. But he was on BBC Breakfast this morning, was it? What day is today? Is this the 29th? No, yesterday morning.
I think it was Johnny Walker. Correct me if I'm wrong. But Johnny Walker had that as his sig tune. And Johnny Walker was talking to Dwayne Eddy. This was only a couple of months ago. And he was saying to him, Johnny Walker was filling in for somebody. Mm-hmm. And he was saying, I said, I loved that. He said, it put me in a great mood. And I put that signature tune on. He said, it set the whole program up for me. And Dwayne Eddy says, and he said, I don't use it anymore. And Dwayne Eddy says, why? And he says, because some man in a suit decided we don't need sig tunes anymore.
That's right. So they stopped me too. Yeah. Remember, I used to have signature tunes. They're very important, you know. They lift you.
Yes, they don't.
Because your signature tune is usually something that you really, really like. Yes. I had two signature tunes. My first one was Housewife Choice, because that reminded me. Do you know what it reminded me of? It reminded me of being a child and going to school. Because I used to go to the Christian Brothers school.
But Brian...
Yeah, I'm not finished.
I know, but Brian Matthews has still used a sig tune.
I know, but maybe they couldn't find him. See, when they find you, they tell you what not to do. If they don't find you, you keep doing it. I used to walk to school through the bog side. Mm-hmm. That's before the Troubles. You know, there's 50 people in the house. And used to walk past these little terrace houses. And I'd be going over and I'd be trying to get to school for 9 o'clock. And I'd be late. Mm-hmm. And the only reason I knew I'd be late was because out of the windows would come the signature tune of Housewife's Choice. And that meant that it was 9 o'clock, and that meant that I was late. That meant that I'd get a good strapping. But I used to like that because I didn't care, because I knew that it was just show business. And then I had another one too, The Big Country.
That's right.
I loved that. That used to make me feel big.
But why did the man in the suit decide that the people didn't want signature tunes? Why did he decide this and just say, I don't want signature tunes, stop them, the BBC?
This is what the BBC does. There are men in office.
But that's people who never present the programmes. Well,
they claim that
they don't know.
They claim that they do research and then they find out these things, but I don't believe
that's them. A lot of nonsense.
Dwayne Eddy was on BBC Breakfast this morning. While he spoke, underneath his name at the bottom of the screen came the word musician. Surely there's no need to explain who he is. Well, I fear so. I was reading an article the other day, and do you know this? And I know this to be true. In a technical school, what was it, a technical school? Was it university? No, sorry, excuse me. It was university that did the survey, mm-hmm. and 98% of the students had no idea who John Wayne was.
Is that right?
But you see, that is not surprising, because you and I know, but look at the state of us. Yeah. But then again, not everyone knows everything like I do. Did you know that Dwayne Eddy performed at Glastonbury? Did you know that?
No, didn't.
And I'm guessing that there were a few youngsters who hadn't heard of him until then. Come to think of it, my youngsters didn't seem to know him. Okay, I'm wrong. Put musician below his name then. Forget I ever spoke.
I'm bringing back the sick tune this afternoon.
Do it!
Yes, no, I'm stealing 40 miles of bad road. I'm introducing the programme with
them. They'll sack you!
No, they won't.
They will!
They will not.
They will sack you!
No.
You have to go out and work somewhere.
You're showing a bit of flair. I'm bringing back the sick tune.
Don't do it.
I will.
I'm going to tell them you're going to do it. They'll stop you. Stop it.
I'm going to do it today.
Stop it, you rebel.
What do you get when you fall in love? A girl with a pin to burst your bubble. That's what you get for all your trouble. I'll never fall in love.
get when you fall in love? Nothing but pain, lies and sorrow. So for at least until tomorrow, I'll never fall in love again.
Plastic Jesus sitting on the dashboard of my car. Comes in colors pink and pleasant. It glows in the dark, it's iridescent. I take it with me when I travel far. Get yourself Madonna dressed in rhinestones and sitting on a pedestal of abalone shell. Just doing 99 and scary because I've got the Virgin Mary assuring me that I won't go to plastic Jesus, plastic Jesus, sitting on the dashboard of my car. Plastic Jesus, plastic Jesus, I take it with me when I travel far. I don't care if it rains or freezes, as long as I've got my plastic Jesus sitting on. Abalone, abalone, doing 99, it's scary, cause I've got the Virgin Mary assuring me that I won't go to hell. Plastic Jesus, plastic Jesus, sitting on the dashboard of my car. Plastic Jesus, plastic Jesus, side chicken. Ha ha!
she's my hope.
Can't catch me.
She's the place where I stash my dope. He's sitting on the dashboard of my car. He don't slip and he don't slide, because his eyes is magnetized. He's sitting on the dashboard of my car. Plastic Jesus, plastic Jesus, sitting on the dashboard of my car. And I'm afraid I have to go, this magnet is my radio. I'm plastic Jesus, you won't get me far.
There was a particularly vicious and, I have to say, totally unnecessary DJ trap at the end of that. Also, did you notice that the volume there just went down almost 50% during the course of that?
Having said that...
So that's not my fault.
Yeah, well, Ballymoney listener rings and they say they've been listening to the show for years and the levels are fine. This is an echo now coming back on me.
What is happening here?
I'm hearing myself.
Somebody up in Belfast has turned a switch. Pat and everything in my ear, I hear everything twice.
I'm hearing everything twice now.
See, and everything's not as loud as it was, and we're hearing everything twice. And I haven't done anything. All I did was scratch my leg. Maybe every time I scratch my leg, the volume doubles and everything changes. Anyway, let's not sound as if we're complaining. We'll be back after the news, friendly and nice.
On 92 to 95 FM
and 1341 medium wave,
this is BBC Radio Ulster.
And with the BBC News at 11 o'clock, this is Keith Burnside. Police say they're treating the death of a 29-year-old woman in Carrickfergus as murder. Her body was found last night in Patterson's Row in the town. A 38-year-old man has been arrested. A 56-year-old man arrested in connection with an attempted murder in Polglass on Monday has been released pending further inquiries. A 35-year-old man was shot in the neck in an attack on a house in Glenbourne. The Justice Secretary, Kenneth Clark, has said he intends to clarify the law on self-defence in forthcoming legislation. He said people were entitled to use whatever force was necessary to protect their homes, and a householder who stabbed a burglar would not have committed a criminal offence. Immigration officials say people should be advised not to fly to or from the UK tomorrow because of staff joining the strike over public sector pensions. The border agency has written to the airport's operator, BAA, suggesting it advises passengers not to travel. A fire in the American state of New Mexico is surrounding the Los Alamos nuclear laboratory where the first atomic bomb was developed. A spokesman for the laboratory said the risk to any radioactive material was extremely low. But the 12,000 residents of the town of Los Alamos have been evacuated as a precaution, and nuclear inspectors are travelling to the area. The local fire chief, Doug Tucker, said the fire had reached the perimeter of the lab's large grounds.
Right now it is on the lab border on the south side. That's the only area that is currently touching the border of the lab. It is close on the west side. So we have fire all around the lab on two sides. And when you ask how close it is on the border, it's a road away usually.
Crowds are gathering in front of the Greek Parliament building in Athens, where politicians are preparing to vote on whether or not to approve the ruling socialist government's multi-billion pounds austerity package. Many of the protesters are wearing masks and white face cream to protect them from tear gas in the event of further clashes with police. Sport now. Here's Michael McNamee.
The former Chelsea player Roberto Di Matteo is heading back to Stamford Bridge. He's to be assistant first-team coach under new Chelsea manager Andre Villas-Boas. Northern Ireland have moved up three places in the latest FIFA World Rankings. They're now 62nd, just behind Scotland. The Republic of Ireland go up three spots to 31st. England rise to fourth ahead of Brazil and Argentina. Former Ireland batsman Decker Curry has been banned from all cricket for a year. Andy Murray takes on Feliciano Lopez this afternoon for a place in the Wimbledon semi-finals. And Tiger Woods has praised Rory McIlroy's win in the US Open, describing his 8-shot victory as some seriously good playing. Woods is still unsure if he'll be fit enough to play in the Open Championship at Sandwich next month.
Sunshine and showers are forecast today. With the details, Jackie McCann.
Showers in the west will gradually track eastwards, becoming more widespread by lunchtime. Although there will be some sunny spells on offer, particularly through the morning, the clouds will bubble up this afternoon, with the odd heavy downpour expected to develop. However, some places should completely avoid the showers, enjoying a dry day with highs of 17 Celsius.
BBC News.
BBC Radio Ulster. Travel news.
In Derry, roadworks are taking place on the Craigan Road between the Glen Road and the Springtown Road. As a result, Foyle Town Service 11 for Woodbrook Park will omit Hatmore, Kylemore and Grangemore. For further details, you can contact Foyle Street Bus Station on 7126 2261 or the TransLink Contact Centre on 9066 6630. And on to flights, and the Greek air traffic controller strike continues today, so anyone flying to Greece should check with their airline before travelling to the airport. Aileen Moyna reporting.
Travel news on BBC Radio Ulster.
On Talkback with Wendy Austin today, cruise ship tourists so hassled by tour buses, Belfast City Council has to have its own people at the dock. Should there be a proper code of conduct? Are unemployment figures rising? Could the fairy job mother sort things out? She'll be on the programme today. Could she help you get a job? Do you support the public sector strikes? Are immigration and customs staff right to go out tomorrow over pensions? If you're trying to leave the UK or get home tomorrow, you could be lucky. And trash the wedding dress photographs, the latest craze for brides. The idea is to jump in the sea or a river after the ceremony to have some pictures taken. But the dresses cost a fortune. What are these women thinking of? If you've done it, call us and join the debate on Talkback at 12.
Thank you, Wendy. I've done it. But I'm not calling anybody. Did you hear the weather girl saying that there were showers on offer today?
All right, Elisa McNeice, who's a nurse. You're looking for her. All right, then.
So am I.
What's your phone number?
Here's a version of Madame George you don't hear too often. Bob Kennedy, Energy Orchard.
Down on Cypress Avenue, the childlike vision sweeping into view. Click and clack of the high heel shoes, from the Fitzroy, Madame George. Matt Singh with a soldier boy behind. He's much older now with hat on, drinking wine. And the smell of sweet perfume comes drifting through the cool night air like Shalimar. Outside they're making all the stops, kids out on the street collecting bottle tops, going for cigarettes and matches in the shops. I'll be taking Madame George. It's when you're born. And you fall into a trance, sitting on a sofa playing games of chance. And you fold it out in history books you glance into the eyes, Madame George. And you think you found the bag, you're getting weaker now and your knees begin to sag. And I called up playing dominoes and drive the one and only Madame George. Yeah.
outside the frosty window rack. She jumps up and says, Lord have mercy, but I think it's a cop. And immediately she drops everything, everything she got. Down onto the street below. And you know you gotta go. On that train from Dublin up to Sandy Road. Throwing pennies at the bridges down below. In the rain, hail, sleet and snow. Say goodbye. Dry your eyes, Madam George. Wonder why, Madam George. Say goodbye, say goodbye, say goodbye.
That couldn't be anybody else but Seasick Steve. That's a song called You Can't Teach an Old Dog New Tricks from his new album of the same title. I'd love to hear Daniel O'Donnell singing that.
What about the song beforehand?
I'm going to back reference many of these songs because we've had some inquiries about that. Mm-hmm. The song before that was, of course, Madam George.
Yes.
Sung by Bappa Kennedy and Energy Orchard from some years back.
Can I tell you?
Yes, you can.
I didn't like it.
I understand.
I'll tell you why. No, but I'll tell you why. Because I like Bap Kennedy, fine singer. Uh-huh. But you stop listening to Bap. You know, when Van Morrison sings the song, Van almost it's compelling. Listen, you sit and you listen to the story unfold. I started off listening to Bap, and then I found myself talking to Emma. Then I found myself doing other things. I drifted away.
I hope not with Emma.
No, I know. You understand.
That's all right.
I drifted away into doing other things, and he was still singing the Bible. But when Van sings that song, you sit and you listen to it.
You do indeed.
So Van's the only man can sing it?
I don't think so, no.
Not
I
right
think
then.
Bap did a passable job on that. And before that, we had I Never Fall in Love Again by, who do you think sang that?
I never heard it.
I thought you were sitting there listening. Maybe you were doing things with Emma then.
Before the news.
Deacon Blue. It was.
Right.
Deacon Blue, that was.
What I'll Never Fall in Love Again, was that?
What
do you get oh, I hated
when
that
you...
song.
I know you hate it, of course you do.
I must have switched off.
You must have switched off mentally.
What do you call her? What do you call her, the recorder? Was it Ginny? It wasn't Ginny. No, Bobby Gentry? No, what do you call... Was it...
Will you stop?
Ach, would you help me? Can you not see I'm struggling for the Garrison?
I don't want you to struggle. I want you to shut up. That was Deacon Blue.
But who recorded it?
I don't care.
Oh, please tell me.
It was somebody called Bobby.
Bobby Gentry?
I don't know. Maybe. I don't know. It doesn't matter.
What
is this, a quiz?
No,
or as you say, a quiz?
I never liked it.
I know you didn't like it. You don't like anything.
No, I never.
That's all right. It's okay. It's all right not to like. I expect
it. I'll tell you another one I didn't like. You know the one about the guy jumps off the bridge? Tallahassee, whatever it's called, bridge.
Billy Joe McAllister fell off the Ballyhatchie. Billy Joe McAllister ran off the Ballinafay Bridge. Billy Joe McAllister ran off the top, jumped off the. What is it?
Billy Joe McAllister
jumped off the Tallahatchie Bridge.
Yeah.
What's so difficult about that?
What's it called?
Also, Billy Joe. Oh, to Billy Joe.
I never liked that song.
Actually, you don't like anything. That's why I play everything that you don't like, because I get a kick out of it. Also, we had a song there called Plastic Jesus, which was sung by Dan Donnelly. A lot of people like that.
A lot of reaction to that.
Negative and
positive. No.
Years since I heard Plastic Jesus. Details, please. Singer, CD, etc. Well, it's Dan Donnelly, and it's from his new album, which, well, it's only been out, well, it's been out at the end of last year, I think.
What Donnelly's he?
Donnelly from the back of the wall.
No, but
his brother used to be married to a hairdresser.
Is he a Belfast?
But he joined the army.
Where is he?
What?
Where's he from?
He's from Belfast.
That's a mask, idiot. That's what Donnelly's
he? I'm just about to tell you if you'd shut up. Dan Donnelly from Belfast. That's a song called Plastic Jesus. He didn't write that himself. That's written by somebody else. And it's from his album, which is called Country and Northern. As opposed to, see what he did there? See what he did there? Country and Western. Country and Northern. And there's a website, www.sonofagun.com. www.sonofagun.com. And that's available. Dan Donnelly's been in this programme a couple of times, and I'm going to ask him to come in again if he ever feels like it, because I think he's a great talent altogether. Overheard in the car showroom yesterday, there's Nolan, the biggest in the showroom. I didn't read the other word. I have to say thank you to Mal Kearney. He sent me 5-6 CDs of wonderful music. I played a couple of the tracks today. I'd like to thank you, Mal. The reason why I didn't thank you earlier is because I'm an ignorant wee, you know. I hear that the CDs I've sent to you have arrived. I'm sure your listeners would hate Tiptoe Through the Tulips by Tiny Tim. All the more reason to play it in heavy rotation. Do you like Tiptoe Through the Tulips by Tiny Tim?
Not particularly.
Do you want me to play it for you?
No, again.
All right. I'll play it later.
Mary phoned in. She's quite upset because Mary...
What seems to be the trouble with Mary?
Mary in Craig Avon, she lost her clatter ring at Sainsbury's in Craig Avon. And she's 40 years. Very sentimental. And she said, if anyone finds that clatter ring at Sainsbury's and Craig Avon, would they hand it in, please?
Just good to show the nature.
Means so much to her.
I understand that. A clatter ring, lovely thing. I haven't done it. I did a documentary about the clatter ring. I was down there. Do you know anything about clatter?
No.
Wonderful story. Clada is a kind of a little village outside Galway. It's a little fishing community. It's in Galway, but it's not of Galway. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Many, many years ago when the world was young and you know, Johnny Walker was on the air.
Right.
The Vikings came. But anyway, there was a wall built around Galway. But the Claddagh was a kind of a beyond the pale in a way. They were different people. They were fishermen and they had their own community. They spoke their own language, basically. They had their own music and their own songs. And for some reason, they became associated. They didn't make gold rings, but they became associated with it. And you know the symbol on the Claddagh ring?
Yeah, the two
clasped
hands.
Clasped hands and the heart.
Yeah, yeah.
That's said to have Roman origins.
Right.
Even though the Romans never came here because they were afraid of Protestants.
Right.
The Romans never came here. But that somehow they have a whole, that's an amazing story. And people there who are descended from those people are still quite, you know, they keep themselves apart.
But why did they use the, what's...
Nobody
story.
Knows.
Nobody knows.
Nobody knows.
Was there a couple? Absolutely
nobody knows. There's a couple of legends, but of course they're not true. Yeah. Nobody knows the reasons why.
But there's a way of wearing the ring, isn't there?
I mean, yes.
If you're married and if you're single.
If the heart is pointed outwards, it means that the person is looking for a partner.
Uh-huh.
If the heart is pointing inwards, it means that person has found the person of their dreams. If the wing is in its pocket, it means they're going out for a drink. Wedding ring off. Omo, old man out, wedding ring off.
There's a wee call.
I know. I didn't know, I just pretended I knew. Yeah. Hello, good morning. Well, oh, this is the first call of the day, I see. Because there's no one there. Emma, will you do whatever it is you do with your finger to make the people hear me?
Tell me one.
Yes, there's nobody there.
There has to be. You've been fiddling with things.
No, it's Emma. Will you go over?
Look, everyone's.
You come on.
There.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Thank you. That's the thing that you should have done beforehand.
But someone was in.
There was nobody. Listen, why don't you admit that you always forget to do the thing that Emma must make you do?
He in there.
Can't blame him.
The undertone in the.
I saw you putting your finger over and doing something.
I went over. I check your thing every. Your
screen.
Your screen. I check your screen.
I'm sorry. I'm turning him off. I'm sorry you had to listen to this caller.
Don't worry at all. I'm well used to listening to the show.
It's quite all right. You know what's coming. Anyway, what can we do for you today? Never mind the squabbling.
We have a charity event on Sunday, so it's on the 3rd of July at 11 a.m.
Yes.
It's called Mini in the Garden, and we try to get as many classic minis from all over Northern Ireland and Ireland to come park in the garden, enjoy a family day of activity, lots of quizzes, lots of prizes, and a big barbecue.
Sorry for interrupting you. Are these old minis? Do you prefer vintage minis or just any kind?
It is mostly old minis, but we don't turn anyone away.
Well, what about the minis that they have now? Do you know the Mini Coopers, the black and white ones? You see them all. Everybody has them. Well, they're lovely. Do they count?
No, we let them in.
Anybody comes? All right. Do you know the nice white ones and black and a lot of girls have them?
Yeah. Well, my mum has one, so we can't really put her out of her own garden. So
actually, do you notice that, Sean? Do you know those wee white cars that people have, the wee Mini Coopers? It's always very good-looking girls driving them.
Who?
Do you know those little white Mini Coopers?
Yes.
They're kind of white and they've got a black top. And,
yes.
And invariably, there's a lot of them about. They're lovely wee cars. And apparently, it's nearly 9 times out of 10, there's always a very attractive girl driving.
It's always girls driving, that's right.
Always
right.
Attractive, though.
Yeah.
Do you know the way when you see people driving big, expensive Mercedes, they're always dogs? Well, do you notice that?
I wouldn't go that far. It's a bit strong, isn't it? I had a Mini Cooper.
I know, but...
I had a turquoise blue and one with a white roof, but she had a faulty sump.
Story of my life. sorry, get back to the minis. So when are you doing this?
Okay, so it's on this Sunday at 11 a.m.
Okay, and where will this be?
It's at One Everglades in Ballycastle.
One Everglades in Ballycastle. So on Sunday. So people are encouraged.
BT546BE for anyone with sat nav.
I have no idea.
And it's
an aid
of the Northern Ireland Hospice.
It's for the Northern Ireland.
Your levels are away again.
I know, it's not my fault. It's not my fault. There's something happening. There's something in the ether. No, what the lady is saying is she's putting in her postcode into the sat-nav. Do you not know about that?
No.
If you put your postcode...
I don't know. I don't think I've ever been in a car with a sat-nav.
Never?
Never. I've never experienced it.
That explains a lot. If you put your postcode into the sat-nav, it will take you wherever you want to go, but you have to drive the car itself. So that's on what is that again? It's for, sorry, I was distracted there. Give me that information again.
Right.
Yeah.
It's on this Sunday at 11 a.m. in Ballycastle.
Yes.
It's near the Northern Ireland Hospice.
Yes.
It's called Minnie in the Garden.
Yes.
And there's lots of quizzes. There's a big barbecue. There's lots of activities during the day and lots of prizes to be won. Four quizzes and four different car categories, like the best car or the furthest travel, different things like that will get prizes.
All right, then. And it's to raise money for the Northern Ireland Hospice?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you very much. Hope you have a good turnout.
That's brilliant, Jerry. Thank you very much for letting us on.
Not at all. Thank you. Bye.
Thank you.
Bye. Bye. Lost cat, a young black cat with a pink diamante collar with a bell, went missing from the Newington Limestone Road area of North Belfast since Monday night. Also lost, a female wristwatch in Newry yesterday around the Butter Crane shopping centre. I'm very good at that kind of announcement, aren't I? Did you notice that?
There's another call for him too.
His role shooting dice in the Jim Saloon in El Paso one night back in 1895. For a while, he just sat there, watched the game, brooding, mad. And then he drew a pistol and said, "Give me my money back." And the timid soul handling the cash of the house said, "Take it all, Mr. Harden, it belongs to you." Harden got arrested for it the next day, but nobody thought to ask him to return the money. He did get told not to play that way anymore. I know a man whose plow handle hand is quicker than a light. Wes Harden is his name, they say, and he travels in the night. For he might have to kill or walk around the fight. And if you ever saw Wes Harden draw, you know he can skin his gun. Won't say how many tried and died up against the top hand, up against the wrong man, 'cause Harden wouldn't run. Well, he rode in like a Texas wind, and he took the eastbound train, going, going with Jane Bowen, till the lawman called up. "So long, Jane, and chin up, I'll be back again." Well, off went to Huntsville prison, "So long, Jane," he cried. 15 years she waited till her heart broke and she died. Then she left that bad land to wait up in the sky. Chug-a-lug in red.
That's Steve Earle, of course. That's a song called Harden Wouldn't Run, Wes Harden, of course. And that's a song by, I don't know if it was written by Johnny Cash. I think it was, but he certainly recorded it. A little reaction, Rory McIlroy's appearance at Wimbledon yesterday. Now, don't get me wrong here.
Mm-hmm.
He's great, but the wee lad, he's only 22, and there's nobody telling him what to do. Somebody should tell him what to do. Rory's appearance, in addition to his poor dress sense, which I'm afraid he didn't look, he looked terrible. His image was not improved by his standing with his hands in his pockets. But you see, that's what you do when you're 22. Mm. Can you remember what you were like when you were 22? Of course, you were never 22. You were born when you were 60.
No, I remember. I
think he should come to me.
Yeah.
I noticed that he's becoming friendly with Paddy Kilty. That's always a very bad sign. Lost cat. No, I've done that already.
What about the call?
What call?
Two.
Two, two. Hello, good morning. Hello, good morning.
What are you on?
I'm on two.
Well, hello, Columba should be there.
Columba may not be there.
Look.
Emma, will you put your finger over where it should be? Hello?
Hello, Jerry.
Thank you, he put his finger over.
I never touched...
Twice you've done that.
Look.
Twice you pretended not to...
I didn't touch it.
Twice you pretended not to do anything.
He didn't speak. Columba didn't speak.
Columba, did you hear me long before I spoke?
I did, but it was sure no one wanted to talk to. Not you. Not well,
talk to him,
you see.
He wants to talk to you. Go on, talk to him then.
Hello, Columba.
Hello, Sean.
Broke yes, Columba.
Blamed it on St. Paul.
What?
St. Columba broke a wonder. And blamed it. That's what we used to sing in church.
Now, you were talking, that song, was that not Sandy Posey, that?
Who wrote that?
No, that, you, that one that you played by Deacon Blue.
No, that it was Ode to Billy Joe.
What are you talking about? It wasn't Ode to Billy Joe.
It was.
It was called Raindrops Keep Falling on My Head, or whatever you call it.
No, it was Ode to Billy Joe.
No, it wasn't. It was called I'll Never Fall in Love Again.
No, the one...
It was I'll Never Fall in Love Again. Was that not...
I mean, which song are you talking about, Columba?
He's talking about...
I'll Never Fall in Love Again.
One, yes, I'll Never Fall in Love Again. That was Bobby Gentry.
Was it?
Yeah.
That's all
what did Sandy Posey sing then?
Single girl.
Sang everything else.
Single girl. I'm a single girl. Remember that one? All alone in the great big...
I'm just going to leave them for a while because I can sense a very boring conversation coming up and it may last for some time. I can usually judge how long these conversations will last. There will be talk of Sandy Posey. There will be talk of Birmingham. Sean will tell him about how he used to make fire guards. He will tell him about Tom Jones's night robe and how his mother put it in the bin because she thought he was too close to her. He will tell her about how horrible, he will tell him about how horrible I am. And then they will talk about Dave D. Dozy Beaky McIntitch. And then he will ask him, does he play golf? I don't know what stage they're at yet.
There was two, but I mean, Single Gear was one, the other one, I forget, it was a big hit. I was just come back from...
It's early yet. There may be a couple of minutes that I may have to leave them entirely. I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll interrupt them.
Listen, this is great.
Maybe we could move on.
How long ago was that? I think I just came back from England when that was a hit. Single girl.
Why can't we just move?
I can't even hear you, Sean.
Oh, sorry. I beg your pardon. A Sandy Posey. I think she had two big hits.
Are you sure you got that right?
Yeah.
Yes, she had two.
two big hits. Yes. Are you okay? Is there anything else you want to know, sir? You'll notice that I'm keen to move
on. But it wasn't Sandy Posey.
Well, she had banned the gold, hadn't she?
No, that was Frida Payne.
Oh, was it?
Yeah.
Well, then check out Sandy Posey.
For what?
For why?
I Never Fall in Love Again.
No, Bobby Gentry.
But you see, maybe the man is right. Maybe Sandy Posey did record that. Emma?
Do you want to oogle? Oh, the oogle. Do you want to oogle?
Will you oogle, Emma? And
will
see if
oogle?
Sandy Posey
Sandy,
ever...
Sandy Posey.
S-A-N-D-Y-P-O-S-E-Y. E-Y. Did she ever record I'll Never Fall in Love Again? Mm. What do you get when you fall in love? A guy with a...
pin to burst your bubble after he... After
I nearly said something else.
I know. That's why I was in like Flint there.
She's very slow.
But she's googling.
I've noticed she's got very slow.
Yeah. But do you want to hear...
I don't know what he wants.
Columba, what do you want to hear that song? No, she never. Sandy Posey never recorded it. We've just Googled.
Your arse is parsley. She never recorded it.
Never.
I'm not often right, but I'm wrong again.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Yeah.
Listen, come back again sometime when you're not sure of something. Then we'll tell you you're wrong. Okay.
Right, good night.
Good night, Andy.
Good night. Good night to you, sir. I'm just looking at the...
There's another call.
Is there? Mm. I wonder, will it work?
Hello.
Yes, good morning.
Good morning, Jerry.
How are you?
I could be worse.
Thank you.
But now, listen.
Yes?
The other day, I was listening to Radio Erin.
That'll be RTE.
RTE, sir. Yes.
Yes.
And they were talking about that somebody discovered a 1941 Spitfire that had crashed in Donegal.
That's right, yes.
Did you hear anything about that?
I heard all about it, yeah.
Did you?
It crashed, where did that crash?
It's
70 years ago, 1941.
Was it
1941.
It crashed into a bog, didn't it?
That's right.
In Donegal. Whereabouts?
It's in all the papers today.
All the papers today.
Oh, is it in the papers today?
Yes.
It's all right, right. Because I was just wondering where it was. But there was a fascinating story about the pilot.
It was all over Radio Foyle and Radio Ulster yesterday. The pilot parachuted free.
Yes.
He escaped. He didn't crash. He didn't crash with the plane.
That's right.
And he would be 95 now.
I mean, did you hear what happened to him after that?
I don't know. I wasn't following the story, to
well,
be honest.
Well, he parachuted out of the plane.
Yes.
He was arrested by the Gardaí.
Yes.
And he was interned in Southern Ireland. And now, because he was an American, they wouldn't let him go because they didn't want to end up the neutrality bit about the war.
That's right. They don't call it the war. Well, they call it the emergency.
Emergency. He escaped from there and got back to Northern Ireland again. He was actually stationed in Limavady.
So, in other words, he escaped from Limavady?
No, he escaped from Southern Ireland, from the internment camp.
He escaped from Southern Ireland during the war.
and he got back to Northern Ireland again, and he finished up the war... I think he's fighting out in the Middle East or somewhere.
Is that a fact?
Yeah.
I must actually follow that story because...
They're going to make a film of it, and I was just wondering when will it be coming out, I wonder.
But was he not handed back then? It became a whole diplomatic row.
That's
so
right, there was, yes.
Went as far as Hitler.
That's right.
And Churchill.
Yeah.
And it was decided the best thing would be that he give himself up and go back to the guards.
That's true.
And serve his time there, or something like that.
Didn't want a diplomatic incident, right.
I feel terrible because I know nothing about
this. Is that right, Jerry?
I haven't read that
story
at all.
Jerry, you've got to play golf to know these stories.
Oh.
You see. If you're a golfer, you get to know all these stories because this is what they talk about in the clubhouse after they've made a mess of the round of golf, you know.
Oh, I know what they talk about.
You know,
it's not about prisoner of war.
They go in there and tell you the ones they missed and they nearly tell you that the hole moved when they were putting.
Listen, I'm sorry. I'm normally on top of this kind of thing, but I was very busy yesterday.
Right.
I didn't read or look at anything.
Well, now ask your friend there. What paper was that in today?
I have no friends here.
Well, you have.
I think it's...
I'll ask him. What paper was that in?
I think it's in the newsletter and in the Irish News today.
Yeah, that's good. Yeah. Oh, well, okay. I'll look it up.
I must read that myself. Okay, sir.
Listen, thank you very much.
Not at all, thank you.
Go back to sleep again.
Thank you.
Down by Black tiptoe by the garden, over a low tree, come tiptoe through the tulips with me. Lady, in flowers we'll stray, we'll keep the shower.
No one has ever made a record like that since. That's Tiny Tim, Tiptoe Through the Tulips. And before that was a band from Northern Ireland whom I think are great, and they're called The Salt Flats, featuring Cara Cowan and various other people. That was a song called Blackwater Side from the Northern Ireland Music Compilation 2011. And you say there is a...
Is that the original version of
yes.
Tiptoe Through the Tulips?
Yeah. Yeah, it is, yeah.
I had a different version in my head.
That's because you were younger then.
Is that what it was?
Yeah. A gentleman writes to me and he said, I listened to you on the medium wave on my Walkman. I decided to turn that crap off, but I switched to FM by mistake. The 10 most hated people. Did you know if you switch from 1345 medium wave to the FM frequency, you get Frank Mitchell on U105? Did you know that? Then a thought entered my head, following on from the question you asked Sean about a person he hated. Why doesn't Frank do the 10 most hated people in Northern Ireland? I think I'd be in there. You know?
Mm.
Do you not think so? I think I've got a place there. The 10 most hated places. There'd be great competition for that. The 10 most hated pubs. Wouldn't that be great? I would watch that, would you?
I would.
The 10 most hated types of pet. That would be difficult because you'd be entering the reptile kingdom then, wouldn't you? The 10 most hated restaurants. You can imagine queuing up to be on that one, eh? The 10 most hated walks. What's the walk that you most hate? You walk all the time.
I walk all the time. Any walk that you walk back, you know, the same journey that you've just travelled. I don't like that.
Any walk that you
you go somewhere and you've got to go back the same road.
Ah, you like a circular walk.
Yes,
man. Good idea. Yeah. The 10 most hated sayings. I know what mine. Keep her lit.
No, mine's is what's the crack, or any crack.
What's a crack with you? That's the one I hate. When you stand in the toilet.
Any crack?
When you stand in the toilet, no doing what you do in the toilet. You're standing
washing
there.
Your hands. Fella,
no, not washing hair, your hands.
Combing your hair.
Peeing.
Right.
And you're standing there and a fella comes and stops you saying, what's a crack with you? What do you say?
I know.
What do you say?
What's a crack?
Because they wait for an answer.
They wait for an answer. And if you don't give them an answer, then you're...
They get annoyed. You're a man and ask them what a crack was. What's the way you mean? Never said nothing. Jeez, I don't know. I don't
what are you to say to that?
What do you say to that? The 10 most... Keep her lit. Or flash the lights.
Ach, no, they're just passing things, you know. People get fed up with them. They grow out of...
Barry McElduff got great mileage out of Keep Her Lit. Did you not see that? Mileage out of it.
No, is that who started that?
No, he didn't start it. He said it one time. It was like wee Paddy Jenkins. Remember that ad? Shopping centre in Ballymena, hey?
Hmm.
That's the type of things that catch on.
Well, who was
that's the kind of a nation we are.
Who was the lady on the TV? It says you will, you will, you will. Who was that?
Pauline McLean.
Was that in Father Ted?
Father Ted. Yeah, you will, you will, you will.
That's hers.
That's the type of things catch on.
Yeah. But they pass then, don't they?
They don't. No, they keep on going. I said this before. There's two phrases which live in the south of Ireland. And I bet you don't know. I think I may have asked you this before.
You did, and I never heard it until you asked me.
There are two phrases that people still say in the south of Ireland, which originated from 1960s television shows. And the reason why they've lasted is because people
Southern Ireland didn't get their own TV station, RTE, until the 60s.
I never
and
heard
all
it.
All the programmes that they saw there are deeply, deeply, people of a certain vintage, all the programmes are deeply entrenched in their brains because they were the first time they ever saw them. And certain sayings have remained in the language. And if you listen very carefully, this is a little competition. Next time you're in Dublin, just keep your eyes open, keep your ears open, and have a listen for two particular sayings which are from two well-known television programmes. Actually, one very well-known television programme and another one that people never even heard of.
I never heard of any of them.
One of them was called Quicksilver, which was presented by Bunny Carr. Yes. Hello, my name is Bunny Carr. You're watching Quicksilver. It was a kind of a quiz show. And right. What they had in front of it, a series of lights.
Mm-hmm.
And if you knew the answer to a particular question, you'd say the lights would be on and they'd flicker all the time. The yes. lights would be flicker. And if you knew the answer, you'd ask for the lights to be stopped. Right?
Yes.
Because you knew the answer. So Bunny would say, the lights are on. What's the answer to the question? If you know it, say no. And if you knew the answer to it, stop the lights.
Yeah. I never heard that before.
And now when you hear people...
Did you ever hear that, Emma? Emma never heard it before.
Emma doesn't go anywhere. She's married with a child. What does she know?
Right.
But if you're in Dublin, you'll hear somebody say, oh, Jason, stop the lights. Yeah. Stop the lights, mister. And the other one is... I can't remember what the other one was. It was from Get Smart.
Go on, what?
Would you believe? Do you ever hear people saying, ask Emma that. Do you ever hear people say in Dublin, would you believe?
Everybody says that, Emma said.
No, they don't. It's the way you
would
say
you believe?
It. Would you believe?
I never heard that either. Would you believe?
Would you believe? They say that in Dublin. Hey, mister, would you believe?
And when do you say it? Well, I never said, would you believe where I was last night?
No, when you're about to tell a lie. Right. If I say to you,
right,
I believe you won £1 million in the lottery.
Right.
Your answer might be, would you believe 100,000? See, you're compounding a lie. See, you're saying a thing which is ridiculous. You say
no,
something
that's
to
not
me.
Good to give another example. That's no,
no
good.
No, you're saying something to me. You're saying something to me.
I haven't said anything to you.
Just like I'm talking like that.
Yes, I hear
if
you.
If you say something to me that is patently ridiculous, I will answer by saying something less ridiculous. In other words, if you said to me...
I'll say to you, I believe, Jerry, you're making a comeback in the band scene.
No, that's not ridiculous. That's possible. No, I want you to say something entire. I believe you're going to Mars in a spaceship.
No.
Go on, say that.
I don't
that.
Want to say that. I
say
believe.
That.
I want to say. I believe you're also doing the London Marathon as well as the New York Marathon.
That's not ridiculous. That's
ridiculous.
No,
the very fact you're doing that.
No, what I'm saying to you is, you have to say something ridiculous to me to allow me to employ the "Would you believe?" You have to say
all
something
right,
that's totally untrue.
Right.
You know, will you please say what I ask you to say?
No, I'll say to you. Could I not say you're getting a transplant or something, or getting the next?
I am. No, say to me.
What?
I believe you won £1 million in the lottery.
That's not ridiculous.
Will you say it? Because I said, ridiculous. When was the last time you won £1 million in the lottery? It's impossible.
It is not.
All right then, okay.
I know a man won 7.6 million.
All right then. Well, it's unlikely, yes. Okay? And I would say, in my head, I'd say, that's ridiculous.
All right, I believe you're going to Mars then. I believe you won the lottery.
All right, no, it's Mars. Come on, Mars.
I believe you've put your name down for Mars.
Would you believe Saturn? That's what you say, would you believe? But you don't say Saturn, you say, would you believe? In other words, you're going to answer in a way that is equally ridiculous, but you don't finish it.
Is that the same as I tell that to the Marines?
Or your sister didn't say that last night? Is there someone on the phone here?
I don't know. Yes, there was. There is.
Well, let's try one. Hello, is there someone there?
Yes, I'm still here.
I'm sorry for keeping you so long.
I've nodded off there, boys. I'm sorry. I think everybody else turned off after Tiny Tim.
We had stuff to talk about. All right, go ahead. You have a couple of minutes yet. Go ahead.
A couple of wee things to raise, boys. Just, is Jordy still on the go? Need to know if
yes,
Jordy's still...
Yes, he is indeed.
I have a wee bit of a problem, or my brother is a bit of a problem. I spoke to my mate, who's a bit of a junior Jordy, but he's maybe a wee bit more ruthless, you know.
Uh-huh.
My brother's got a bit of a plague of grey squirrel about the farm,
uh-huh,
and they keep eating the strawberries.
They're the ones that you don't want.
Yes.
That's
now,
right.
At the minute, Dara said, if I just tell you, he's given them a bit of a bath, But my mate says that you can actually eat grey squirrel. They're very tasty. Now, I don't know if Geordie has any experience in grey squirrel.
Well, you can eat grey squirrel if you've been in the siege of Derry for like 4 months and they're eating mice and rats. A squirrel would be a nice change.
Geordie's on too.
Yes, no, is he?
Yes.
You're joking. But
do you want to talk to him?
Oh, brilliant. Get Geordie on.
Geordie.
Ach, what are you doing now? What have you done?
Do your finger, will you?
What? Is Geordie on?
Do your finger. Do your finger.
I'm doing me. The finger is all over the place.
I hear Geordie.
He can hear. It's your end. It's not my end.
It is.
It's not my end.
It's not a shuffle. No, there's something very badly wrong there. I'm sorry about
this. Where's Shane? Where's the engineer?
He's having a haircut.
The screens are everything.
Sagam.
I'm sure Geordie's, and we're going to try and get Geordie. Tell him what. So the problem is the brown squirrel. Is that what you're saying
here? Grey squirrel. Yeah. No,
oh, the brown one's the one that you want.
There's a man coming in to stand over your shoulder.
Is there?
Yeah.
Stand behind you. There's a man in there now.
What do you do with the grey squirrel without being too cruel? And B, can I give them to my mate to eat? Are they edible?
What's Geordie there now?
Hello?
He's
like
way
in the
distance.
Way in the distance.
It's your end.
It's not my end. Geordie.
Hello, Jerry.
There you are.
Ah, you see.
I didn't do a thing.
What's this man's name, the other man?
Hello.
Dave.
Dave. Dave, you can talk to Geordie.
Geordie.
Yes.
That's
grey squirrels eating strawberries.
Yeah.
What are we going to do with them?
Well, you know.
Take the strawberries away.
Yeah, I was going to the
air one. Remove the strawberries.
Get him the air gun.
No!
You're lovely, you know.
Well, that's what he was saying. He thinks they're worth a nibble.
Yes, they're lovely to eat.
Have you ever eaten a grey squirrel?
Oh, I've eaten dozens.
Is that right, boy?
I don't know about how we stand on this.
Your levels are very low.
I know they are. He's fitting with them.
Well, Geordie says just... they're edible, that's good enough for me. We'll start...
I wouldn't take his word for it, Geordie. Let's probe him further. Geordie, under what conditions did you eat squirrels?
Any conditions.
Well, do you boil them or what do you do?
A state of hunger.
You skin them.
You skin them. What, do you put them on a spit or something, do you?
And put them in the pan.
All right, what do they taste like, if I may?
Oh, lovely.
Like,
oh, sweet.
Chicken
or... Oh, Jesus, they're sweet as honey. Man, you're chewing the bones.
I think that's enough information. Thank you, Geordie.
Here, Jerry, before we go.
Yes.
Bit of bad news.
Oh, dear, what's that?
Old Blazer.
Pardon?
Blazer.
Blazer, yes.
My mare.
Yeah?
She's dead.
Oh,
such a sad
piece
of news.
I called her wee fool Janet.
Janet has been orphaned. What happened, Blazer?
Well, she had a twisted gut. They've had out in them, but they said no, our time's up.
Our time? What age was she?
27.
That's old, you know.
What?
That's old for a horse.
Ah.
That's like 80, isn't it, in human terms?
Well.
But she had a good run, hadn't she?
Ah, but she left a lovely wee dude behind her.
Wee Janet. All right then. Sorry to hear that, Geordie.
There's another question for Geordie.
Oh, the white head.
Don't be so insensitive.
I'm trying to. Was Blazer put down then, Geordie?
No, she's just slept away.
She
slipped away. Now, don't you be so cheeky.
Listen, there's a wee question here about hens.
Okay, go ahead.
A lady has got hens, but the wee house is on concrete. Is that okay, or would it be better on grass?
No.
What?
No. Worst thing she could ever do.
Right.
No.
Put it on grass.
Yes, cut a sod or two.
And let them peck.
Hens don't like concrete.
Let them poke and poke.
Give them piles.
And get worms and stuff.
Exactly. Get worms and put them in. Right, Geordie, thank you.
So, Jerry, any more to this?
Not until next year.
What?
The bus run, yeah. Not until next year. Stop asking me that every time you're on. I will let you know when the bus is ready. I'm sorry to be so brusque with you, but time is...
I tell you, yes. Now, Londonderry or Stoke City is getting some
press, yes.
They're getting some publicity.
The city's getting off its knees. Yes.
And do you know where I'm invited to?
What?
I'm invited to the Conciliar in Armagh.
Have you any idea what he's saying, Sean? Would that be the conservatory?
No, the cathedral.
The what?
What's he saying?
The cathedral.
Yeah, for what?
Thanks, Dave.
Thank you, Dave.
Thousands of pounds restoring it.
Indeed, yes, Armagh Cathedral. Are you really invited to it?
Yes.
That's a great honour and a privilege.
Aye.
It is. Well, when are you going to whatever ceremony will be performed?
I'll go on next week.
Next week? Well, what are you going to wear?
What?
What are you going to wear?
I'll dumb out a clean shirt or something.
You need to make some kind of effort, you know, because everybody be dressed up to the nines.
Are you not coming?
No, I haven't been invited. But not that I expect to be, but everybody be wearing their best bib and tucker. You can't be coming along there in an old...
Oh, no, I'll not let them down, Jerry.
I know you won't, but you see, you might need...
Well, I'm highly honoured to be asked.
Indeed, it's a great honour, and I suppose the man in charge of issuing the invitation would ultimately have been the Archbishop.
And I know what he says.
What did he say?
What did he say? Jordy, you are a star. You look after the humble people and the dumb animals.
Is this from the noble mouth of the primate of all Ireland?
What?
Is this from the primate of all Ireland?
Uh-huh.
You see? Recognition at last.
No, I'm a Protestant. Look, I'll go. You know, well, I'm going. I'm highly honoured to be invited.
Well, I think it's great. Wonderful hands across the sea.
Whatever, the new bridge.
Indeed.
This is the new bridge.
See, this is what it's all about. Inclusion. Well, Jordy, when are you going, did you say?
I'm going next Wednesday.
Well, I hope you have a great day. And will you ring us up and tell us how you got on?
Will you not come?
Well, I don't like to go if I haven't been invited. Tell the primate I said hello.
I'm surprised you haven't been invited.
Listen, can I just say to Dave,
we have to go here.
Dave, we'll ring you back in the morning, Dave, and we'll finish your conversation, Dave, all right?
Boys, could I just make two quick nominees?
No, we're right now. We have to
go.
Bye.
I'll see you tomorrow.
Goodbye.
It's 12 o'clock. This is Talk Back with Wendy Austin.